Hello, today we are going to learn about the Stria of Gennari. So this is a typical NEET PG question. This was actually asked in one of the NEET PG examinations. And the question is, the stria of Gennari is seen in A, frontal lobe, B, parietal lobe, C, occipital lobe, and D, temporal lobe. So that means the stria of Gennari is seen in some part of the cerebrum, and we need to know which part of the cerebrum it is. So to understand which part of the cerebrum it is, we'll have a look at an application called 4D anatomy. This is a sagittal section, a parasagittal section of the head and neck, in which you can also see the brain over here. And let us have a closer view into the cerebrum, into the cerebral cortices of this, to understand where the stripe of Gennari or the stria of Gennari is. So I'm going to zoom into the brain. Okay, and I can also move, I can pan this, I can also rotate this image. So that is the ability of this 4D anatomy platform. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom it further, and I want you to have a look and try to identify as many landmarks as possible. So you can understand that this is the corpus callosum with its genu in front, with the splenium behind, and this is the body or the trunk. Okay, and this will be the rostrum of this corpus callosum. So this is the medial surface view, and you can see that in the cerebrum, you can see that this is the cingulate sulcus, and the cingulate sulcus characteristically has an upturned margin. This part is called towards the margin of the cerebrum. This is called the pars marginalis part of the cingulate sulcus. So just in front of that, this will be the central sulcus. Okay, and this will be the parieto-occipital sulcus, and this will be the calcarine sulcus. Okay, it is slightly interrupted because this is a paramedian section. Okay, these are some of the very important sulci that you will be able to visualize in a parasagittal section in the cerebrum. So obviously this is the front side and this is the back side. So this is the anterior side and this is the posterior side. Okay, so in this you'll be able to understand that this is the frontal lobe of the cerebrum, because that is in front of the central sulcus. This will be the parietal lobe of the cerebrum, because that is behind the central sulcus and in front of the parieto-occipital sulcus. And this will undoubtedly be the occipital lobe that will be behind the parieto-occipital sulcus. The occipital lobe includes the cuneus bounded by the parieto-occipital sulcus in front and the calcarine sulcus behind. Okay, so with this much idea, let us have a look into the cortex of the frontal lobe. In the frontal lobe, you can clearly identify that this is the cortex. What I have marked blue thickness is the cortex, and this is the white matter beneath it. Okay, just like you can see here also, there is a cortex and this is the white matter beneath it. The pattern is very similar throughout the general parts of the cortex in the cerebrum. But if I compare that with this part in the occipital lobe, if I go specifically into the region near the calcarine sulcus, I'm sure that you can identify that this is the parieto-occipital sulcus and this will be the calcarine sulcus. So if you look very close to the calcarine sulcus, I want you to have a look at a very peculiar aspect of the calcarine sulcus. Okay, this much part, that is the cortex, and within that cortex, I'm going to take another color. Within that cortex, you can see a white colored stripe. Okay, I've marked a part of it with pink, but you can see the rest of that pink, of that white colored part. Okay, that much part within the cortex. You have to understand that that blue part is the cortex, and in that, parallel to the surface of the cerebrum or surface of the or the pia mater, parallel to the pia mater, you have a white colored stripe, a white colored line, and that is called the stria, or the line, or the stripe of Gennari. And this stripe is typically seen only in the calcarine sulcus, only related to the calcarine cortex, related to the primary visual cortex. Okay, this is the reason why the visual cortex is also called the striate cortex. Okay, because it is it has a stria of Gennari, and this, that is why it is called a striated cortex. So you can understand that this is actually a gross anatomical feature. If you look carefully, if you have a hand lens with you, and if you look at a gross anatomy specimen, you can see this stripe of Gennari. You can see this deep calcarine sulcus. In this calcarine sulcus, again, you can, if you look at the cortex, this much thickness is the cortex. Okay, you can see that white stripe of Gennari. I'm putting a dotted line over here. That is a white stripe of Gennari. Okay. So, what is the stripe of Gennari? The stripe of Gennari is actually, this is the typical section, a histology section of the cerebral cortex, contains different layers. Okay, there are six layers of the cerebral cortex. You can see a different video of mine where I have described this six layers. It's a very clear laminar arrangement of six layers within the cerebral cortex. In that, the layer number four, this is will be the layer number four, and that layer number four typically contains a parallel or a horizontal arrangement of white fibers, which here in this section where you have a Luxol fast blue, it has a blue colored stripe, and that is called the external band of Baillarger, external band of Baillarger. The external band of Baillarger, you also have an internal band of Baillarger deep to it, corresponding to the layer number 5. But corresponding to the external band of Baillarger, in the visual cortex area, you have that region, that external band of Baillarger is typically very thick. Very thick, and that creates the stripe of Gennari or the stria of Gennari. Okay, and that is the reason why you have the stripe of Gennari arrangement. And this was found by Francisco Gennari in the year 1776. Okay, that's in the 18th century. So you have to understand that that was a time even before this lamina pattern of the cerebral cortex was identified. This person, who was actually a medical student, he identified in a coronal section. You can see his description here. This is his paper, and this description, you can see within this occipital cortex, you can see a white line. Okay, that white line is the stripe or the stria of Gennari. Okay, so the answer for this is occipital lobe. The other questions that can be asked here is, in which layer is stripe of Gennari found out? The answer is it is just an extension or a modification of the external band of Baillarger. External band of Baillarger. How will you remember it is external band of Baillarger? I suggest you remember that there is an E here. So that can be a mnemonic. You can use that mnemonic here. So that corresponds to external band of Baillarger. The layer number in the cerebral cortical layers, it is layer number 4. Okay, so these two are also potential MCQs. Okay, so these three are potential MCQs related to the stria of Gennari. So thank you.